Hey, what's up, guys? My name is David of davidglenrecording.com and theproaudiophiles.com, coming at you with a vocal tutorial. I'm sitting here going over a whole outline and notes galore on a new training course I'm putting together, all things vocals, mixing vocals, A to Z with my walkthrough, the things that I'm going to do to clean it up, blah, blah, blah. And then stylistically, I'm going to pull in a hip-hop vocal, a pop vocal, a singer-songwriter. I've got a live gospel vocal, all kinds of good stuff. But I'm going through this, and I'm working on a video, and I typically use clip gain in Pro Tools to, let me put these notes away here. I use clip gain to clean up phrase by phrase, section by section a lot to help what gets sent into the compressors to be a little more level, a little more balanced, so that high points can kind of come down a little bit, just to make the compressor's job a little bit easier. And that's been a process of mine for a little bit now. But I was working on this, and something that I thought of was Dave Pensado on Pensado's Place. There's an ITO where he talks about mixing vocals, and he brings up Christina Aguilara, I believe, and how much character and emotion she puts at the starts of her phrases and the ending of her phrases. And I started thinking that, you know, compression's great. I love compression just like the next guy. But I came across this technique. I started wiggling the mouse a little bit. You'll see that in a minute. And it kind of just, I don't know, kind of shook me to the core. One of those moments that I just kind of like, oh my gosh, like I got to share this and see what other people think about it. I'm not even saying that this is the way to go. This is like, man, we should all be doing this. I want this to be a conceptual discussion almost, what you think about it and how you like the vibe of it. So I'm going to shut up. I'm going to hit play. This is a phrase we're working with. Cool. Short and sweet. Now, I'm going to put a breakpoint right here. I've got the smart tool open. If you don't know got the hand, if you hold command, it'll pop open so you can add a breakpoint. I'm going to put one at the high point there. I've got one here to prevent anything to the right of that breakpoint from being affected by this move. I'm going to add one here in between them, and then watch. I'm just kind of pulling up the sustain of that note. Isn't that crazy? So that's awesome. I've done that with vocal automation before, but doing it with clip gain, I don't know. There was something that as I started doing this, it just sounded pretty sweet. So I'm going to pull this back a little more subtle. I'm going to do the same thing over here. I'm going to put a breakpoint at that high point there in the wave, and then I've got the breakpoint here. And then if you click and drag, obviously you can make someone real articulate and go through and boost some of their phrases, but let's try something like this. Cool. Without it. With it. Cool. I don't have any compression. This was a Harry late night in the studio one night. I think he pulled a U87 into the control room. He's got a MIDI keyboard in there, and that's that. So maybe I'm making a big deal out of nothing, but I'd love to hear your thoughts on it. Leave me some comments. This to me was just was a sweet little trick to pull open some sustain. You can come in here, fatten it up a little bit, maybe even come out here to this breakpoint and boost the breath so you can really hear what's going on there. You can see it, got a nice graphic. Yeah, no, not that. So win some, you lose some. But let me know what you think. The starting, the ending of phrases, how important that can be to the character and emotion of a performance, a vocal. It could be for guitars. It could be for anything, really. I'd love to hear what you think. So feel free to like, subscribe, leave some comments in the section below. And don't forget to check out davidglenrecording.com and theproaudiophiles.com. And we'll catch you on the next one.